We got Wendell Potter on the line with us. He's a former health insurance industry executive, the author of Deadly Spin, A Nation on the Tank, A Take. His latest project is Tarbell.org, T-A-R-B-E-L-L.org. It's an independent nonprofit digital newsroom showing how money and politics impacts millions of Americans. His website, Wendell with two L's, Potter.com. You can tweet him at WendellPotter.com. And Wendell, welcome back to the program.
Thanks so much, Tom. Glad to be back.
Great to have you with us. I understand that California is taking possibly a serious shot at single payer. Do I have that right?
That's exactly right. We've got a bill that was introduced in both the Assembly and the Senate on Friday that would create a single payer system in California. This is really, really big news. It's a very important milestone, and I think we're going to find it's going to have a lot of support.
So how will it work, and you know, what are the provisions of the bill?
The bill itself at this point is there just isn't a lot of language there, but it just it's kind of it would provide the framework or would authorize the state to move forward to develop a single-payer plan. So that's much work obviously has to be done, but it is the first bill that's been introduced in the California legislature in some time. As you may remember, the California legislature has actually passed a single-payer bill twice back during the years when Arnold Schwarzenegger...
Well, that's right. He vetoed them, didn't he?
He vetoed both. And so we're now seeing that with a governor who's a Democrat... Democrats having a supermajority in the legislature, this very well could go through.
That's amazing. You know, Schwarzenegger could have been the Tommy Douglas of the United States.
We're going to find that there's a lot of business support this time around. There's an organization that's coming together called the Business Leaders Transforming Healthcare that's being put together by business leaders under the auspices of the American Sustainable Business Council. And in fact, a businessman who I have gotten to know who produced a documentary called Fix It Healthcare is leading that effort. And that's another documentary I would hope that your listeners and viewers would take a look at. Go to fixithealthcare.org and you'll be able to see it.
Yeah. Oh, excuse me. pardon me. So what can, forgive me, Wendell, just inhaled some water. What can people who are, presumably anybody who's in California, what they can do is, you know, call their assembly or member or their senator and say, hey, please support this. What can people who are outside California do? Or is this something where we just have to kind of stand back and let's see what happens in the Golden State?
Well, I think it would be great for Californians certainly to contact their legislator. In fact, I think it'd be great for them to contact the authors of the bill. It's Senator Ricardo Lara, L-A-R-A, is the Senate sponsor, and
Assemblyman.
It's co-authored, by the way, by Senator Tony Adkins, San Diego. So I would. Most definitely reach out to them, but yes, they should reach out to their legislators, and those of us who live in the rest of the country, I think it'd be useful to reach out to the Physicians for National Healthcare, which is a national organization.
That's PNHC.org.
Yeah, exactly. And Healthcare Now is very much an operating organization in California, and so there are a number of organizations that are active, but at the national level, Physicians for National Healthcare and Healthcare Now.
I'm guessing National Nurses United are big on this too.
Sorry, say that again.
I'm guessing National Nurses United are big on this too.
Exactly.
The Nurses
National
Union.
National Nurses United is a big single payer advocate, has been for many years, and they are based in California as well too, in the Bay Area.
Yeah, this is amazing. What you know, California is the sixth or seventh largest economy in the world. Certainly, they won't have the problem that Vermont had of not having enough, even though Vermont passed a single-payer program, that with only 600,000 people in the state, they weren't able to generate the critical mass necessary to do a real insurance program that could protect everybody. California should be able to easily do that, but that's going to mean that the five or six big companies, and you can let me know how many still exist now, big health insurance companies, are going to lose tens or hundreds of billions of dollars in revenue. And I'm guessing that they will, at the very least, pour hundreds of millions of dollars into fighting this thing, won't they?
There's no doubt that's true. I should say that when the legislature passed those two bills during the Schwarzenegger years, the industry didn't pour a lot of money into it because they felt pretty certain that Schwarzenegger would veto it, and he did. They could count on him. This time around, it's a different ballgame. So I suspect you'll see that they will be beginning to pour a lot of money into California to defeat it. Now, this is legislation, though. It's not a ballot initiative. We saw a ballot initiative in Colorado be defeated last year. And the reason for that was because the industry poured millions of dollars into Colorado to defeat it. So ballot initiatives are not so easy to pass because of the ability of industry to just inundate a state with money. The legislature is a different creature. So even if they spend a lot of money, there's a good chance that this could really keep moving forward.
Yeah. How long do you think it'll take?
You know, I think chances are it may not get through the legislature this year. We'll have to see. I know some of the candidates who are running to succeed Brown are also single-payer supporters. So if it doesn't get through this year, I think it could next. Now, one of the things that I think is behind this is what's happening in Washington and who knows what's going to happen to the Affordable Care Act. Now that the Republicans rule that town, it's very uncertain, and that's creating a lot of uncertainty in California. And the folks out there really want to try to get ahead of the game and be ready with legislation because very, very likely the bottom's going to fall out of the healthcare system pretty soon, depending on what the Republicans do.
Yeah, and that's going to create a real sense of urgency out there. That's fascinating. Wendell Potter, tarbell.org, the website, wendellpotter.com as well, and you can tweet him at Wendell Potter, WendellPotter.com. Wendell, thank you so much.
Anytime, Tom. Thank you.
Great news. Great talking with you. We'll be right back.